model who comes to mind. Maybe it's a celebrity, a parent, or a grandparent. Well, mine is my best friend's mom, Nissa Bambino. She became the mom who I didn't have, and she's a very important person to me. She's an amazing business owner, survivor, mother, wife, and friend. I was introduced to her when I was 2 years old. She was really good friends with my dad, and she babysat me. I became really close friends with her daughter, Lily, who is the same age as me, and ever since then, we've been best friends. She welcomed me with open arms and an open heart, and I was included in many family events and activities. I even have been on trips with them. She's also always involved in my school academics and extracurriculars. She was a florist, and on every single day of my birthday, she would send me flowers at school. She created a lasting impact on my life from a young age, and we've been very close ever since. Aside from the honorable impact she's had on my life, she also showed honorable strength when she got very sick in 2018. What she thought was just a common stomach flu turned into much more. Unfortunately, it was multi-organ failure. This was caused by a health supplement. Ironic, I know. She was life-flighted at the University of Washington's Medical Center because the critical condition she was in was undiagnosable in its early stages. She was put into a medically induced coma for 10 days, and at this point, doctors thought these would be her last days and insisted that all of her friends and family said their goodbyes. And being 6 hours away is really hard for Lily and I because she was in Seattle and we were in North Idaho, and it was the middle of our school year. After her coma and she was moved to the ICU, she spent a lot of time there, but eventually she slowly recovered and was eventually moved to a closer hospital and then a rehabilitation center. Through all of this, she maintained a very grounded mentality and made light of her very unfortunate situation. She suffered lots of trauma. She lost her ability to walk, suffered hair loss, and had a few of her fingers partially amputated. After 2 years, though, she returned to good health and back to her normal lifestyle. In conclusion, I'm lucky she's who I get to call mom. She's taught me that family is not always blood, but the people who love you unconditionally.